mindful of me. Let you hear me when I call. Is it true you are thinking of me? How you love me? It's amazing. lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show. So glad you're in my heart. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave.
Welcome to Lighthouse Updates!
Hi, I'm Sai.
Ako naman si Jay.
At kami ang maghahatid sa inyo ng mga updates ng mangyayari sa ating simbahan.
At dahil MGCQ na, matapos ang matagal na paghihintay, magkakasama na po tayo ulit.
At bilang parte ng new normal, ito ang ilan sa mga pwede nating tandaan sa pagbabalik natin sa ating simbahan.
Mga bagay na dapat tandaan bago pumasok sa simbahan.
Step 1. Register. Bago tayo pumunta sa ating simbahan, mayroon tayong registration through Google Form that we can access via QR code or link na ipopost sa ating Facebook page. Alinsunod, na rin sa IATF Guidelines for Community Quarantine.
Sa pag-reserve ng seat sa ating services, may ipopost na online form sa ating Facebook group every Monday. Hanggang Thursday lang po pwedeng mag-register. At kung sakali namang gusto natin mag-cancel, ay mangyari lamang kung paalam ito agad sa amin para bibigay natin yung seats na sa iba.
Number of seats that are still available due to cancellation will be posted every Friday at our Facebook group, Lighthouse Center. We discourage walk-ins, so we encourage you to register first before coming to church. Also note that minor will not be allowed to enter.
Step 2. Get scanned and sanitized. Kung nami-miss nyo po ang ushers, handa na po sila sa ating pagbabalik. Meron pong alcohol stations para mag-sanitize ng kamay at thermal scanners para iscan ang ating body temperature. Ang mga taong may temperature na mas mababa sa 37 degrees Celsius ang mga ari lamang pumasa.
Kapag pumasa ang inyong temperatura sa pamantayan, bibigyan po kayo ng ating usher ng contact tracing form kung saan nyo po isusulat ang ilang importanteng detalye ukol sa inyong kalusugan. At pagkatapos, ay maaari nyo nang makuha sa usher ang inyong seat number. Reminder, always wear your face mask or face shield dahil no face mask or face shield, no entry po tayo.
Pagkakuha po ng seat number, ay mag-disinfect ng footwear sa ating foot pass at tuyuin ito sa ating dry mat.
Ito naman po ang mga paalala during service o kapag nakapasok na tayo sa loob ng simbahan. Number 1, umupo lamang sa inyong assigned seat. Bawal palipat-lipat. Each attendee can sit only on the seats with their seat number.
Number 2, avoid physical contact. Hindi po natin ina-allow ang shaking ng hands at hugging sa ganitong panahon.
And number 3, keep distance or layo-layo muna, bawal beso-beso. Social distancing must be practiced at all times when inside the church premises.
Number 4, wear safety equipment. Lagi po natin isuot ang ating face masks or face shield for protection.
We encourage everyone to bring their own sanitizer and sanitize every 15 minutes.
Sa paggamit ng CR, maghugas ng kamay at gamitin ang provided na alcohol. After natin gumamit, ay i-disinfect ng ushers ang CR at pansamantala itong isasara ng 5 minuto.
Sa ating pagbibigay o offering, iikot po ang ating mga usher upang kolektahin ang ating tithe or offering envelopes. Kung kayo ay nagbigay o magbibigay gamit ang ating online payment channels, maaari isulat na lang ito sa envelope. Also, we encourage you to write your prayer request.
Sa pagdiriwang ng communion na ating ginagawa every first Sunday of the month para maiwasan ang kontaminasyon ng elements, ang servers po ay equipped with gloves sa pagdidistribute ng tinapay at kukuha po tayo ng isa sa magkakalayong cup sa lalagyan para sa ating mga.
Matapos ang gawain, isa-isa po tayong ililid ng ating ushers upang makalabas ng simbahan ng maayos habang pinapractice ang social distancing. Nakakalungkot man, ngunit dilimitahan na po natin ng ating fellowship sa loob ng simbahan. We are encouraging to instead join a discipleship group para makapag-fellowship pa rin tayo sa ating Lighthouse family.
Kung meron po tayong inquiries, huwag po tayong mahiyang magtanong. Send them to our FB page pwede kayo magtanong tayo ng kakilala natin po.
Excited na po kami magkasama-sama tayo ulit.
Patuloy po tayong manalangin para sa bansa at para sa buong mundo sa labang ito against COVID-19.
Mag-ingat!
At patuloy na manalangin.
God bless Lighthouse!
Welcome to Lighthouse Online Service! Kumusta po kayo? Masaya po kaming makasama kayo ngayong araw sa ating online service.
If this is your first time watching our church service, you can comment down below or send a message to this page so we can know how to connect with you. Gusto po namin makilala kayo at makasamang makilala ang Panginoon ng mas mabuti.
We also encourage you to tag your friends, your family, your neighbor, those you know who also need to hear the Word of God. Tag them in the comment section below. By the way, bago namin malimutan, I am Sister Angelica.
And I am Sister Sen. And together, we will bring you today's latest announcements.
We have our morning devotion posted sa ating Facebook group, Lighthouse Center, every Tuesday and Thursday at 6 a.m. We believe that this is a great opportunity to start our days meditating about God's goodness in our lives.
Every Wednesday, meron naman po tayong online prayer meeting via Zoom at 7 p.m. You are free to invite your friends and family dahil open po ito para sa lahat ng gustong makahinga at magpahinga sa presensya ni Lord in the middle of each week.
Every Saturday, we have our Youth Fusion streamed live sa ating Lighthouse Youth Facebook page at 4 p.m. And of course, our Sunday online worship service at 10 a.m. and 6 p.m. via Facebook Live. Pwede rin po natin itong mapanood at mapakinggan sa YouTube at Spotify.
Be a channel of blessing. You can help our church in its ministry by giving your tithes and offering even in the comfort of your home via our online banking and payment channels.
We value having closer relationship with all of you. Kaya naman, aside from our online services, meron din po tayong opportunities to bond and have fellowship with each other. For the young adults, we have our fellowship via Zoom every second and fourth Saturday of the month at 8 p.m. Also, we have our church fellowship every first and third Saturday of the month via Zoom, which opens at 7:30 and starts at 8 p.m.
Para naman po sa mga naggagandahang kababaihan ng Lighthouse, We have our Women's Fellowship every Thursday at 7 p.m. via Zoom pa rin po. Kindly message Sister Tess Romaldes for more information.
We highly encourage you to join Light Groups and Discipleship Groups. So, kindly ask anyone from Lighthouse for more information on how to join. Or you can send a message to this page so we can happily assist you further.
We don't want you to miss out, so we invite you to like, follow, and subscribe to Lighthouse Center in Facebook, YouTube, and Spotify for more updates and announcements. We also encourage you to comment and engage with our fellow believers in the comment section of our posts and videos.
Again, I am Sister Angelica.
And I am Sister Sen.
And this is Lighthouse Center, a church with passion for God
and compassion for people.
For now, let us find our comfortable seats and prepare our hearts to worship God and hear His word for all of us today.
Good day, Church. I'm Christine, one of the volunteers here in Lighthouse. And today, as we start our service, I want to read this verse to you from Psalms chapter 59, verse 16. It says here, "But I will sing of your strength. I will sing aloud of your steadfast love in the morning. For you have been to me a fortress and a refuge in the day of my distress." Kamusta naman po tayo this week? Ang daming nangyayari. Ang dami pa rin nangyayari araw-araw. And I hope na sa dami ng struggles na kinakaharap natin, sa dami ng problema at sa dami ng laban na pinagdadaanan natin araw-araw ay si Lord pa rin at kay Lord pa rin natin kinukuha yung lakas natin. I hope na si Lord pa rin yung nanatiling stronghold natin para magpatuloy at lumaban pa rin araw-araw. And before I pray po, if you have any prayer requests in mind, you can just comment it down or you can also message us in this page, Lighthouse Worship Center, and we would love to pray for you po. So, sige po, let's pray. Lord, salamat, Lord. For this morning, Panginoon, Lord, salamat sa pagising sa amin, God. And God, salamat for this online service, God. And salamat kasi, God, nagagawa pa rin namin, God, na i-worship ka, God, and makinig sa word mo, Panginoon. Every week, God, through this online service. And God, salamat for the whole week, Panginoon, na Ikaw, God, yung naging lakas namin para lumaban, God. Lord, mahirap man yung mga nangyari sa linggong to, Panginoon. Pero salamat, Lord, kasi Ikaw yung lakas namin na dahilan, Lord, kung bakit hanggang ngayon lumalaban pa rin kami. And God, salamat sa word today, Lord, kung ano man yung maririnig naming word, God. Lord, salamat dun, Panginoon, God. Hayaan mo na buksan mo, Lord, yung puso namin ngayon pa lang, God. Na, Lord, matanggap namin sa puso namin, God, kung ano yung gusto mong sabihin, God. Lord, I pray na this word will be personal to us, Panginoon. Na, Lord, hindi lang siya magiging knowledge, God, pero, Lord, magiging experience to sa amin. Salamat, Panginoon. And, Lord, paguhin mo yung puso namin, God, through this service, Lord. Lord, hindi imposible yun, Panginoon, Lord, kahit nasa bahay kami, God. You will be able to reach us, God. Lord, salamat, Lord. Salamat, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Alright, magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Can we give God a clap offering? Lord, good morning. Medyo taasan naman po natin yung energy natin today. Pwede po ba natin isigaw yung pangalan ni Jesus? In 3, 2, 1, Jesus! Lord, good morning. Lord, we praise you and I pray, God, that this will be a time, Lord, where we will please you, where we will worship you, God, more than whatever we will feel, God. We will look to you, Lord, and we will offer you our best worship. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God, we believe in your word. We believe in you. Thank you that your presence is here. You
light is breaking through the dark. This love is sweeter than wine, bringing joy, bringing life. Your hope is rising like the dawn. Will we sing, oh, 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 oh. It's always like, it's always like springtime, here and now, making all things new. Your light is breaking through the dark. This love is wine, bringing joy, bringing life. Your hope is rising like the dawn. Come on, church, this is what you do. And this is what you do. This is what you do. Hey, we come alive. This is what you do. This is what you do. Oh, hey, we come alive. This is what you do. This is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do. This is what you do. You make me come alive. 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 You make me come alive.
It's a new season.
It's like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. Would you say it's like I'm living for the first time? It's like I'm living for the first time. See, Paul, that faith arise. Come on. Prophesy over your lives, over your families, over our church. It's like I'm living for the first time. Amen. It's like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. Come on, believe. It's like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. Of the scripture, pwede pang ipakita natin yun, Matthew 8:5-8. Ito po yung time na may isang centurion na lumapit kay Jesus para pagalingin yung servant niya. And ito po yung sabi. When Jesus returned to Capernaum, a Roman officer came and pleaded with him, "Lord, my young servant lies in bed, paralyzed and in terrible pain." And ang sabi ni Jesus dito, Jesus said, "I will come and heal him." Pero this was the remarkable response of the centurion. Sabi niya dito, the officer said, "Lord, I am not worthy to have you come into my home." And then accepted, sabi niya dito, "Just say the word. Just say the word from where you are, and my servant will be healed." You know, a lot of times we've been praying that, "God, come to my situation. God, please come into this situation." Pero this centurion is different because he said, "God, just say the word." And can we have that today? Now, God, just say the word and I will be free. God, just say the word, I will come alive. Just say the word and I will be healed. So whatever that is, can you lift that burden to God today? And God, and we will pray that, God, just say the word. God, just say the word. See, so begin speaking. Begin boldly declaring. We have a God who answers prayers. We have a God who hears our words. Who hears, who sees our burdens. And we will say, "God, just say the word. God, just say the word. And I will be free. God, just say the word. I will be healed. God, just say the word. I will be restored." Mukhang mahirap. So again, we will sing this with fresh passion and fresh perspective. Now, God, I will not ask you to come into my situation. I will ask you to say the word because your word is enough. Lord, that your word is final, that your word will never come back void. Alright? See, so, are you ready? Can you jump up on your feet for some moment and stir up your faith? Amen. Alright, do you believe in God? Do you believe in Jesus? Alright? So we will declare this over our lives. We will sing this with faith. That God's word is enough. All right. Yo, we'll start slow. This is what you do. And this is what you do. This is what you do.
You make.
Make me come alive. Do. This is what you do.
Begin declaring louder and louder, more bold, more power, more faith. See, for sing this, God sees you. Oh, this is what you do. This is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do. This is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do. This is what
it's a new season. The old has passed away. God says that the old has passed away. It's a new season. It's a new season. It's a new season. Like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. Oh, like I'm living for the first time.
See what you say?
Like I'm living for the first time. Come on, it's like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time.
Come on, more faith. Come on, church, do you believe that God is good? Do you believe that God's word is true? Would you speak that truth in your life with faith today? It's like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. Just say the word, Lord. Say the word, Lord. Louder, louder. It's like I'm living for the first time. Come on. Like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. See, bro, can we raise our hands today? It's like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. It's like louder, louder. It's like I'm living for the first time. 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 I thought I'm living for the first time. And this is what you do. This is what you do. For some moments, let this be our time with the Lord. I believe He's here. And He's not just here, He's speaking. And would you open the ears of your heart today and listen? Say the word, Lord.
Just say the word, Lord. What happened? Be for you. Your word will never return void. Your promise to us, Jesus. You are true, you are faithful. You are healer, you are redeemer of the broken. You are the song of the barren. Oh God, your word never fails, God. You love. What is true?
Just say the word. You're here.
There is a still.
Not to us, Lord, but to your name. Come to us, Lord, what you need. Lord, I pray, Lord, that this moment, Lord, would not go away. I pray, Lord, we will carry this with us, Lord. The impression you made, Lord, this morning. The words you have spoken to us, Lord, while we were worshiping. I pray, Lord, that this will speak to us, Lord. And this will change us, Lord. And not just that, but this will come true, Lord, in our lives. That as we sing, Lord, glory to your name, Lord, our lives will be for your glory. Lord, we are made for you. We are made for you, God. Lord, you are our God, and Lord, we are your people. So let your will be done, Lord, in us, in our lives, wherever we are, God. In all our lives, Lord, be for your glory. I pray, Lord, that right now, Lord, your healing water would flow, your peace, your hope. Not just that, Lord, but you. You will come, Lord, in our hearts once again, Lord. And restore and refresh. You renew and make us whole again. Thank you, Lord, that we can come to you as broken as we are and receive full acceptance, full forgiveness, grace, mercy, love, and every good thing that comes from you, Lord. Lord, we are not worthy. We are not worthy for you to come to our homes. So God, today, we pray, just say the word and we will be. Just say the word and we are healed. Just say the word and we are restored to new life. See, if we can raise our hands. Lord, we receive your word. Because your word is final. We receive your word, Lord, in our lives. God, we receive whatever that may bring, Lord. We're all in. Lord, we surrender. Lord, katulad ng sinabi ng kanta, we will follow you with everything that we have. And Lord, we will follow you. There is no turning back. Lord, we believe that you are still in control in all of this, Lord. In the pandemic, in our lives, in our church, in our workplaces, Lord, in our families. Wherever we find ourselves, Lord, you are still in control and you have the final word over everything in our lives. You have the final word, Jesus. You have the final word. Not our minds, not our hearts, not our feelings. You have the final word. We praise your name, Lord. And we're excited for your word, Lord. We know that we are not done yet. Place our hearts, Lord, in a, place our hearts in a position to receive from you. Lord, we are hungry, we are desperate, Lord, and we are longing for you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Can you put best love offering to God? You can say his name, shout. Jesus! You will be busy, guys.
God, hello po, ako po si Sister Nenet. Good morning po sa lahat, kamusta po tayo? Patuloy lang po tayong manalig sa Panginoon sa anumang problema na dumarating sa buhay natin. Magtiwala lang po tayo at kasama natin si Lord na malulutas anuman ang ating suliranin. Praise God. Meron po ako i-share sa inyong verse. Actually, na-share lang po sa akin ni Sister Testo. I-share ko lang din po sa inyo sa 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 8 to 9. Magagawa ng Diyos na pasaganain kayo sa lahat ng bagay, higit pa sa inyong pangangailangan, upang may magamit kayo sa pagkakawang gawa. Gaya nga na sinasabi sa kasulatan, siya'y namudmod sa mga dukha, walang hanggan ng kanyang kabutihan. Wow, praise God. Thank you, Lord. Hindi pa po tayo nang hihingi na kapag pamudmod na po siya. Ganyan po kabait si Lord. Mula noon hanggang ngayon, ano man yung natatanggap na sa kasalukuyan, alam natin na sa Kanya nang gagaling yun. At paano po natin masusuklian ang kabaitan ni Lord sa pamagitan po ng pagpupuri, pasasalamat, sa paglilingkod sa Kanya. Siyempre, isama natin yung tithes and love offering na maliit man o malaki, hindi po importante yon, alam po natin yon. Ang importante po kay Lord yung laman ng puso natin. Hindi lang sa pagbibigay, sa pumumuhay natin sa araw-araw, alam ni Lord ang laman ng puso natin. Amen po. Manalangin po tayo. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Lord, maraming salamat po sa kabaitan mo. Alam namin, Panginoon, na hindi ka nang hihingi ng anumang kapalit, kundi ang pagsunod lamang sa iyo. Subalit, karapatan namin, Panginoon, na mag-alay sa iyo anuman ang aming makakaya, Panginoon. Sa abot ng aming makakaya, Panginoon, tanggapin mo ko anuman ang aming maiaalay sa inyo. Salamat, Panginoon, sa biyaya mo, hindi lang sa financial, kundi sa pag-iingat mo sa amin sa araw-araw, Panginoon. Lord, maraming salamat sa mga bagay na pinagkakaloob mo at sa kaligtasan namin, Lord. Salamat din po, Panginoon, sa umagang ito na narito po kami at sama-sama muling makikinig na inyong banal na salita. Panginoon, gabayan mo ang bawat isa sa amin. Binabalik namin sa inyo ang buong pasasalamat at papuri, Panginoon, sa pangalan ni Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Ipa-flash po sa screen kung paano po tayo makakapagbigay kay Lord. Thank you po.
Well, this morning, I'm so happy to see all of you, and I hope you are in good condition. Ano man ang kalagayan ninyo, you're maybe going through some kind of problems in your life. You're not feeling well. Well, you know, it's okay. Hindi tayo nag-iisa. Lahat ng tao dumadaan sa problema. At mahalaga ay kapit lang sa Panginoon. Amen? Sabi natin sa katabi natin, kapit lang kay Lord. Ha? Huwag bibitaw, laban lang, at magpatuloy lang. That's the only options we have today, is to continue in our Christian life, to be faithful to God. And just before we hear the Word of God, why don't we close our eyes and let's pray. Panginoon, maraming pong salamat sa inyo sa umagang ito. We thank you, Lord, for this wonderful morning once again. Ibinangon mo kami sa aming mahiga, sa aming mga higa na malakas, taglay ang panibagong sigla sa aming mga katawan at punong-puno ng pag-asa sa dahil ang buhay namin ay nasa sa iyo at ikaw ang nangako na hindi mo kami iiwan at hindi mo kami pababayaan. And today, as we are spending our time together to listen to your word, may you speak to us in a personal way, in a deeper way, that you will open our eyes and our hearts to be blessed by your word that you will bring to us. Salamat, Panginoon, sapagkat alam ko na ang mga sandaling ito ay mahalaga sa inyong harapan, sa mga anak mo na naandito ngayon na nahihirapan, nasasaktan, at nakakadama ng pagkabagot sa kanilang buhay, Panginoon. Alisin mo ang lahat ng kabuisitan sa buhay namin at bigyan mo kami ng kalayaan, ng pananalig at pananampalataya sa inyo, Panginoon, na walang anumang sigalot sa buhay namin ang maaaring mag-down sa amin, sapagkat alam namin that you are still the King of Kings. You were never dethroned from your throne. You are the King of Kings, and you are the Lord of Lords, and you are in control of everything that is happening. Lord, bless your servant and bless your people today as we listen to you in Jesus' name. Lahat po tayo ay magsabi ng malakas na amen. Amen. I'm exerting effort. Brother Joel, can you put more volume in my microphone? And the problem with my voice, mahina ang aking boses. So, pag ako nagsasalita, parang pasigaw kasi hinahabol ko yung lakas ng boses ko. You know, one time I prayed this prayer. Sabi ko, Lord, you know, I have the desires to speak to thousands of people. You know, I got saved during the era of crusades. Sino siya yung naka-attend ng evangelistic crusade? Okay? Itong generation na to, parang hindi kayo bugbog sa crusade. But my generations in the 80s, evangelistic crusade is very prominent. And that was my generation. And somehow, because of that exposure, nalay sa heart ko yung evangelism crusade. Kaya minsan sabi ko, Lord, I want to speak to a crowd. I want to speak. I have burdens for crusade. wala na atang masyadong nag-iisip about mga krusada. Pero ako, sabi ko one time sa asawa ko, ma, gusto ko mag-krusada. Gusto ko nang magsalita sa isang krusada. Tinitingnan ko ang sarili ko na magsasalita ako sa krusada. But the problem is my voice is, sabi ko, naging prayer ko, sabi ko, Lord, gawin mo naman makapal yung boses ko kasi parang ang nipis. Alam mo yung mga broadcaster, pag nagsalita sila, kakapal ng boses nila, ano? Parang hindi ako bagay sa krusada kasi lagi akong nag-exert ng effort, ano? I do not know how will that happen, but, you know, sana tulungan ako ng Panginoon dyan. But, siguro ang boses ko pang classroom lang. But anyway, today, this is not a matter of voice, this is a matter of what God is going to tell us this morning. Kung ano ang sasabihin ng Panginoon. Are you ready? How's your week? Kumusta ang linggo ninyo? Kumusta ang panahon ngayon at ang ulan? Binabaha ba kayo? Kahapon, we have an exciting evening. I was very much relaxed yesterday. My wife asked me to go with her in SM Bacoor. So, I joined her and kumain kami ng aming paboritong noodles doon. Saya-saya ko. Dalawa kami, nagkikwentuhan kami, very much relaxed. At hindi ko alam ang nangyayari sa paligid. At may nag-text sa kanya, ang lakas daw ng ulan. Sabi ko, bigla akong nag-alala at sabi ko, kailangan na siguro nating umuwi. At relax na relax ako, hindi ko akalain na yung bahay pala namin ay nagkaroon ng there was an instant waterfall inside our house. Yung ceiling namin, it's not leaking. No, it's not leaking, it's not dripping, it's showering. There was an instant shower inside of our house, right there in our living room. Pag-akit ko na talagang umulan. Hindi ko alam for some reason, yung pala yung isang gutter namin ay nabarhan. Hindi ko alam paano nakarating yung sachet doon, pero nasa run. Kaya yung volume ng tubig, hindi niya kinaya nung isa at umapaw at yun. Ngayon, kung pupunta kayo sa bahay namin, ang linis ng aming sala. Ang linis. Kasi apat kami nagpunas. Misa kailangan bahain para malinis. Amen? And nakalimutan ko na ang message ko. Sabi ko, pag-uwi ko ng bahay, iriribihin ko yung message ko, pero, you know, biglang nawala, napunta doon sa ceiling, napapunta ako sa taas, inayos ko yung alulod, at inalis ko yung bara, at nagtuloy-tuloy. Naayos naman. At salamat sa Panginoon. I hope your coming to the church today is a result of your love to God. Yung pagpunta natin dito ngayong umaga ay bunga ng ating pagmamahal sa Panginoon. Today, a lot of church people have a valid reason not to go to church. Pastor, I cannot attend the church because it's only 50 persons are allowed. I have to register and I do not want to do that. So, you know. But if you are the kind of Christians you really look up to God as your number one priority in life, then there's no handicap and hindrances that will hinder you if you're coming to the church. Amen? Walang dahilan para hindi tayo pumunta sa simbahan. And today, I want to speak about two words that will make a big contribution in our Christian life. And this is about growth equals change. Okay? Growth equals change. Okay? Everybody say growth. Does anybody here wants to grow? I want to grow. I'm now 51 years old and education is not limited by age. Even at this age, we still want to grow. You want to grow. We all want to grow. Amen? There was a funny story about the father telling his children, sabi nga, oh, my eldest son is fond of doing mathematics. Siguro paglaki nito, when he grow up, he will become an engineer.
Wow.
And the mother said, yeah, I like your idea, sweetheart. Siguro itong anak ko, paglaking to magiging engineer. This is a comedy story, funny story. And the other child was good in drawing. Sabi niya, siguro paglaking ito, magiging ano to, an artist. Yeah, he will graduate of fine arts, something like that. No? And the youngest son was, gumagawa siya, he was making an airplane out of paper. And gumagawa siya, nahirapan ako kasi kailangan ko English, no? Because brother was aeroplano, he's making an airplane out of paper and he was drawing that in the air. It's flying, beautiful. And the husband said, probably sweetheart, when our youngest son grew up, he will become a pilot. Yeah, he will become a pilot. Well, the two, the eldest and the second, became an engineer and became an artist, but the youngest, he didn't made it because he was already 25 years old and still playing airplane. He was a retarded. Hindi siya lumaki. Yung pala, hindi nila alam, mentally retarded yung bata at the age of 25. Now, that was a sad story that if you will not grow, we don't want to be a retarded person. A person who doesn't want to grow is a retarded person. Amen? Now, I want to speak about growth and change. And our text can be found in the book of Romans, chapter 12, verses 1 and 2. Pero I want to put more emphasis on 2, which says, do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world. Huwag tayong makiayon sa takbo ng mundong ito, but be transformed sa halip. Okay, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind and you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will. Huwag tayong makiayon sa takbo ng mundong ito. Sa halip, hayaan nating linisin ng Diyos ang ating mga kaisipan upang maunawa natin ang kanyang kalooban. Sa gayon, magagawa natin kung ano ang mabuti, kalugod-lugod, at ang ganap na kalooban ng Diyos. But I want to put emphasis on, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Everything you do is not a result of simply by you want it. It's the result of conception. The mind is a very vital, important part of our body system. Amen? Ang kaisipan ay, this is the battlefield. Some says, this is the battlefield. This is where all the ideas comes from. Before there will be a result of actions. Amen? And therefore, ang kaisipan ng tao ay mahalaga. Now, all good information and bad information, it originally to all started in the mind. Nagsisimula ito sa ating isipan. And there was one verse that I like in the book of James says that God is tempting me. No one could say that God is tempting me, for no one could be tempted by God, because God cannot be tempted by evil desires. Each one is being tempted. Are you listening? Each one is being tempted when he was, by his own evil desire, if he was dragged and enticed. And when evil desires are conceived, it gives birth to sin. Nanganganak ito ng kasalanan. And when the seed is fully grown, it gives birth to death. Everything starts with the mind. The mind is very important when it comes to growth and change and transformation into our lives. When we got saved, it was not only our spiritual life that was converted into Christianity. Our mind were redeemed. Are you listening? Sa totoo lang, sabi nung isang mangangaral, when we have not came to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ, lahat talaga tayo bobo o mangmang. And I can say that is true. Kasi lahat ng gustuhin natin ay hindi nakakaabot sa katuwiran ng Diyos. Lahat madumi. Okay? But our mind were redeemed. Now, speaking of growth, does anybody would agree that growing is a good thing? na ang paglago ay mabuting bagay. Well, I would like to say that your coming to the church is not a result only of your love to God, but also your willingness to be transformed and to grow and to be changed. Na yung pagpunta natin sa loob ng simbahan ay hindi lamang bunga ng kagustuhan natin na mahalin ng Panginoon, kundi yung kagustuhan din natin na maging bukas para sa pagbabago. Pagbabago ng ating sarili mula sa ganitong level, pataas ng level. Amen? Growing is a good thing. Everybody wants to grow, I think. We don't want to stay baby and child, to be na manatiling bata. But few people actually dedicate themselves to the process. Pero ilang tao lamang, lahat gusto ng paglago, pero ilang tao lamang ang naghahandog ng kanilang sarili para daanan yung proseso yun. Hello? And the Apostle Paul was so strict about this. At one time, he rebuked the born-again believers in the Corinth, the Corinthian people. Sabi niya, you know, brothers, I do not address you. Minsan, ni-rebuke ni Apostle Pablo yung mga mananampalataya sa Corinto. At ang sabi ni Apostle Paul sa kanila, brothers, I do not address you as spiritual people. I address you as worldly people. You are mere infants. Coming from Apostle Paul saying that, manggaling yan sa pastor mo? How would you react to that? Alam mo, ang tagal mo na nag-church hanggang ngayon, kuripot ka pa rin. Hanggang ngayon, baramdamin ka pa rin. Hanggang ngayon, hindi ka pa rin self-centered ka pa rin. You know, I was driving going to the church today and sabi ko, ma, it's Pastor's Appreciation Month. You will appreciate pastors. Well, that's a good program, but sabi ni Mrs., alam mo pa, meron kang tanggapin o wala, okay lang. Sabi ko, ang sakit. At ang sabi ng Mrs. ko, hindi, ganun talaga ang paglilingkod, selfless. And I was reminded of that virtue. Yes, pastoring is selfless. Hello? But selflessness is not exempted to pastors. Christians are also selfless. Hello? We must all be selfless. Now, only a few people will dedicate themselves to the process of growing. Now, before you will grow, there is a process. Hello? Sabi ni Paul, I could not address you, brothers and sisters, as a spiritual people. I address you as worldly. You are merely infants. If there are jealousy, envy, grievousness, merong selosan, pag-aawayan, grudges among you, aren't you the carnal Christians? Are you listening to me? Can I speak that kind of message to you today? Are you able to handle that? Am I able to handle that? Are you listening? You know, I pastored the church at the age of, mga magulat kayo. Nagpastor ako, nagsimula ako magpastor right after graduation from high school. I stayed for 1 year in college, and then I cannot resist the calling of God, so I went to the Bible school. I told to my pastor, Pastor, I would like to go to Bible school, and my pastor was sweeping the floor, my senior pastor. Sabi niya, are you sure? Yeah, I have to go to my pastor because I need a pastor's recommendation. And so I studied there, and at the age of 19, I guess, I was doing pastoral work up until I became a full-time pastor at the age of 20, 21. And I was commissioned to one of the most established next to the mother church, pangalawa sa mga established na simbahan ng I Care Fellowship Olongapo. The main church was I Care Olongapo, a big church with congregation of 500 people. At yung sumunod na established church was San Antonio Zambales, where I met my wife. I Care Fellowship San Antonio. And I was very young at that time. And members of the church were principal, teachers, engineers, And I was only 20 years old. You know? There was some time, the principal have a problem with other members. They will talk to me about their dispute. And I was only 20 counseling them. But some people, may problema sa akin. I was too young. Ang pastor namin, masyadong bata. And the issue there is when you're young, you're probably, the tendency, there is a strong tendency if you're a young pastor that you will commit mistakes in your pastoral work, right? Anything, kasi you're young. You could easily be influenced and everything. John Maxwell, one of the renowned speakers, said, leadership banks into two truths. Are you listening? Leadership banks on the two truths. One, people will criticize you. They will criticize your leadership. And two, criticism will change you. Are you listening? Dalawang katotohanan na sasalig ang liderato. Pastoring is leadership. It's more than the management skill. Because you administer not only with mind, but you administer with heart. Worse, you are not worth compensated. Your life is like an open book to everyone. They could easily criticize you right there and then. You know, before I became a pastor, I was the type of person that is confident to myself. I could express myself to people. But for some reason, for so many years of pastoring, I suddenly felt this kind of awkwardness in my personality. I no longer want to preach in the pulpit. Before I could face all the criticism, nagkaroon ako ng parang traumatic something experience sa buhay ko. Na tuwing may sasabihin sa akin, Pastor, ganito. Biglang tumataas. Ngayon, gano'n ang nangyayari sa akin eh. Just so you will know. Pag sinabi, Pastor, alam ba yung nangyayari ganito? Biglang tumataas yung presyon ko. Hindi naman ako high blood, pero sabi ko, kasi parang natutrauma na ako. Natutrauma ako. At I guess I'm not exempted. I'm not the only one feeling that. And people who are afraid to stand in front are people who are afraid to be criticized. But if you want to grow, this is one thing you have to deal in your life. Are you listening? Growth is a good thing, but only few people, relatively speaking, are dedicated to go through the process. Madaling magsalita, pero pag kayo ang naandito, madali ang magturo ng direksyon, pero ang humawak ng timon, mahirap. Amen? Madali ang sumakay, pero mahirap maging driver. Sabi na ba, ayaw ko mamasada, Pastor, mahirap. Kasi nagdadrive ako, kukuha ako ng bayan, magsusukli ako, ayaw mo nung multitasking. Lalo na ngayon, ang hirap kumuha ng bayan. Kasi naka-plastic yung likod, tapos may maliit lang nabutas. Baka gano'n, apa nagdadrive ka. No? Yes, growth is a good thing. Though few people actually dedicate themselves to the process. Why? Because peak growth requires change. Ang paglago ay nangangailangan ng pagbabago. Do you want to grow? Do you want changes in your life, adjustment? And change is hard for most people. Ang pagbabago ay mahirap sa nakararaming tao. The truth is that without change, growth is impossible. Kung walang pagbabago, imposible ang paglago. Don't tell me you reach your age up until now, kinakain mo pa rin gatas. Naghahanap ka na ngayon ng karne, baka. Come on, Pastor, preach it. I want something, a meaty sermon. Tell me the truth. I want an honest sermon. You know why churches are growing today, like the church day by day? The pastor was so radical when it comes to preaching. One time I heard that Pastor Ed Lapis saying over the radio, sabi niyo sa mga, oh, kayong mga nakiki-church dito sa amin, bumalik na kayo sa mga pastor ninyo. Kasi hindi namin dito tinotolerate yung mga disiplina. Kung nandito kayo, parang mag-aating kayo, dahil nagtatago kayo sa mga pinanggalingan yung malilita church, you go back. You know, hearing those kind of words, it's difficult. Kinalunong ko kayo dito sa aming simbahan sa day by day for a while. Yes, 1, 2, 3 months for your healing process. But now that you're healed, you have to go back now. You cannot stay here forever. Pastor, I do not want to hear that kind of sermon. It's like they're driving me away. When the Apostle Paul was saying that I cannot address you as a spiritual people, you, because you are worldly, you are mere infants. When there's jealousy, grievances, blah, 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 aren't you carnal? Sabi niya. In fact, I want to give you some meaty sermon, but you are not ready to chew it. Hello? Up until now, all your concerns just attend the church, but you do not know what's happening around the church. How the church, paano na itataguy ng simbahan, paano na susustain ng ministry, and everything. Oh, wala kang pakialam doon. Ang pakialam mo lang yung damdamin mo. Yan ang iniisip mo lang. Pero hindi mo iniisip yung mga taong nagtagal, nagtayo, nagbungkal, hanggang maitayo ito at ikaw ay makadalo. Dinatnan mo na lang kami, maganda na ang simbahan. Wala kang naiintindihan sa simula ng lahat. At darating ka dito, madali mo sirain. At baliwalain ang 101% na itinilim ng mga tao, pera, panahon, pangarap na isinuko. Everything of those things with your little petty issues that you keep on insisting. Is that really worth it? Wow, Pastor. That really makes me alive today. How can you grow without you letting know all these things happening? Now that is the process. Pastor, I want to become a pastor. Yeah, I know that. Even you don't tell me that. That's why I was telling you to be involved in the offering. That's how you do. You do, you make the announcement, you do the offering up until the, you put all your attitude there. You know what makes David special? When the Lord sent him in the bush, nung dinala ng Diyos si David, he do his job with all his great attitude up until God elevated him. Are you listening? Now that is the process, and that is not easy. Without this change, then growth is impossible. Most people fight against change. Especially if it will affect them personally. Ayoko to kasi talagang meron akong problema sa insecurity. Some people have problem with superiority. They do not want to speak because when they speak, they dominate. I have problem with jealousy. I was deprived growing up with many things. That is why the effect of me, na ngayon malaki na ako, gusto ko, papansin ako. There are a lot of problems when it comes to our personality. You know, one novelist by the name of Leo Tolstoy says, everyone thinks of changing the world, but no one would like to change himself. Lahat nag-iisip na baguhin ang mundo. Pero yung sarili niya, Alexander the Great says, I've conquered the world. There's only one thing that I cannot conquer. I cannot conquer myself. Because that is the issue of you between you and the Lord. But no one thinks of changing himself. And the ironic thing is that change is inevitable. Ang isang bagay na nakakamangha tungkol sa growth, yung pagbabago ay hindi pwedeng iwasan. You cannot remain child forever. Are you listening? Hindi ka pwedeng manatiling bata habang buhay. Hindi mo maiiwasan ito. And everybody has to deal with it in their lives. And on the other hand, growth is optional. Sa kabilang banda, ang pagbabago ay optional. It's up to you if you want to remain like that. You know, I've given some people up in my lives. People, no matter how I encourage them to attend the church and read their Bible, they just simply cannot do it. I have no options but to leave that to them. But if I were you, I will choose that my heart will be cut and grow. You can choose to grow or to fight it, but follow these people. But know this, people unwilling to grow, listen to this, people unwilling to grow will never reach their full potential. Yung mga tao na hindi naghahangad ng pagbabago sa kanilang buhay, ay hindi nila maaabot ang kanilang potential. Someone says, never fear failure. Never feel failure, but be terrified of regrets. One of the billionaires today, the founder of Alibaba.com, by the name of Jack Ma, says, it's okay to commit mistakes. Because every mistake, listen, every mistake, he said, is a revenue for success. Hello? Huwag tayong matakot magkamali. Bawat pagkakamali ay isang matibay na katuruan para sa tagumpay. Are you listening? Making the change from being an occasional learner to someone dedicated to personal growth is tough. Yung pagbabago na nakabase sa mga okasyon lamang at hindi nagtalaga na personal na pagbabago ay mahirap. It goes against the grain of the way most people live. You know, most people celebrate when they receive their diploma or degree and say to themselves, may mga tao na pagkatapos nila mag-aral at tumanggap ng diploma at degree, at sasabihin nila, thank goodness, that's over. I'm done with studying. But that kind of thinking doesn't take you any higher than average. All trainings in the world could provide you only a limited success. Are you listening? When you graduate, you face the reality of life. Dati, wala kang iniisip. All you're thinking is yourself. You go out of the house and anytime you go back, it's okay. Minsan, I feel awkward with my children are telling me, Pa, alis muna ako. How can you say no to a 24 years old guy? Malaki ka na. Alam mo nang bumalik. Minsan si Sam, he was 7 years old, sabi niya, Pa, susunod ako sa McDonald's. Sasakay ako ng jeep. Marunong ka ba mag-commute? Now you're not thinking of anyone, you're thinking only of yourself. You visit my house, you eat there, sleep, then you go home. Then all of a sudden, you get married, for example, nag-asawa ka. Ngayon, nagbago na lahat. When Jesus was telling to Peter, now I'm dinadamitan kita, but do you know, Peter, that there will come a day that I will no longer do this. It's you who will doing this to other people. You know, consider David in his battle with Goliath. This is his breakthrough in his life, na nakilala siya ng buong bayan ng Israel. All of his life, he was hiding in the bush, tending the flocks, killing the lions. Nothing special about David. He was just a simple guy. Then all of a sudden, there was an opportunity that comes out in Israel. There was a giant by the name of Goliath who wants to slew all the Israelite people, and the whole Israel army pulled back in fear. No one dare take the challenge of Goliath. Walang gustong lumabat kay Goliath. When you consider David in his battle with Goliath, why was he able to stand against the giant when the army of Israel pulled back in fear? Here's how David did this. His perspective differed from others. When everybody was in fear, he saw an opportunity. Hello? You know, there's many things happening around the world. There's this, a war may break anytime between Taiwan and China. There's this global worldwide epidemics, not of AIDS, but of coronavirus. We still not have resolved AIDS yet, and then there's another pandemic. It paralyzed all companies. Unemployment rate becomes too high. There is mass layoff, mga walang trabaho. Pero bibilib ka naman sa mga Pilipino, talagang meron tayo mga kanya-kanyang paraan para mabuhay when everybody has to live and everybody has to survive. Natutuwa ako sa isang testimony ng isang FA ng Cebu Pacific flight attendant. He was employed for 6 years in Cebu Pacific as flight attendant, and all of a sudden, she lost the job because of pandemic. And she was comforting herself every day because she was crying, umiyak siya. And she told herself one day, sabi niya, okay, tomorrow you must be okay. She was talking to herself, tomorrow you'll be okay. You don't cry anymore. Tomorrow is another day. You have to take this challenge. And you know what happened? She resolved to become a businesswoman. Nagdi-deliver siya ng mga gasol ngayon sa bahay. Somehow she was managed to fight to what is happening, the big adjustment. Oh, di ba flight attendant ka? But ngayon, no. You must find another recourse up route. Are you listening? You know, why he stand out, David, why he stand out? His conviction differed from others. He heard Goliath's threats against the God of Israel and knew God could beat him. We have different kind of conviction. Iba-iba ang ating mga conviction. Meron tayong malalim na conviction. Natutuwa ako sa mga, marinig ko lang, hindi man ginagawa, pero pag naririnig ko, natutuwa na ako kasi may apoy yung puso niya. Sabi niya, Pastor, kasama mo ako dyan sa pagtatayo ng church na yan. Nagugulat ako. Sabi ko, hindi ko alam na may apoy ka palang gano'n sa puso mo. At, nakakatuwang marinig yung mga gano'ng bagay. His attitude is different from others. Attitude is very important. Hello? When it comes to pursuing the will of God in our lives, amen? When everybody says no, you say yes. Hello? Hindi namin kaya yan, Pastor. Pero hindi, gagawin natin yan. You know, when Moses sent the 12 spies in Canaan, which the Lord promised them to be their promised land, 10 of them returned with bad reports. Sabi niya, it's impossible that we could conquer that place because people, there are giants. Nag-evolve lang si Goliath, pero yung pa rin yung giants from the tribe of Nephilim. Hello, are you listening? Those people are giants. We cannot conquer them. People there, ang lalaki ng kamay, ang lalaki ng paa. Kayang-kaya tayong apakan na yan, lilit natin, mga bansot lang tayo. Ano natin magagawa ito? But two of them came with good reports, sabi niya. Let's take up the territory that God has given to us. Amen? And Joshua and Caleb said, people there are seem like grasshopper. And then, sabi ng bad reports, the bad reports said that 10 spies said, we seem like grasshopper in their own eyes. They already judged themselves. Sabi niya, parang tayong mga tipaklong sa kanilang paningin, talang lalaki nila. But two of them came, at sabi ni Joshua and Caleb, no. Surely, God has given us the land and we will be able to conquer it. Amen? You know, everything starts with how you perceive things. Amen? How many of you are thankful that you have problems? Ilan sa ating dito ang masaya na meron tayong problema? Tony Robbins, one of the motivational speakers, says, every problem is a gift. Without the problem, he said, we will not grow. Hello? Are you listening? Ang bawat problema ay regalo, at kung walang problema, hindi tayo ilalago. It is usually easier to change it. It is usually easier to present change as a simple refinement of the way we've been doing it. Ganito lang kami, Pastor, pero we're just refining it. But again, you still tackle the same problem the way you used to do it in an old-fashioned way. Now, when you present change, it falls into 5 categories. People react. When a proposal for change is introduced in an organization, people fall into 5 categories in terms of the response. This is a different kind of growth. There's the innovators, there's the early adapters, there's the middle adapters, late adapters, and the laggards. What is the innovators? This is what we want to be. Ito ang gusto natin, that we will be innovative people. There are the originators of new ideas. But sadly, generally, they are not acknowledged. These kind of leaders are not acknowledged, though they are also... Dito lang gagaling yung mga magagandang ideas. Dito lang gagaling yung mga willing to expand, willing to be improved, willing to be developed. Are you listening? Ito yung mga taong gusto pa nilang matuto. Ito yung mga taong gusto pa nilang lumawak. You know, you know, it's so funny to see, you know, how politicians are fighting, you know. And because it's a U.S. election is coming near, you know how two politicians are fighting and they're throwing bad words against another politics. And I was watching this program about mouthing Donald Trump. Sabi niya, you are the most arrogant, stubborn. Lahat na ng masasakit na salita. And I don't think you are equipped and qualified to become the president of the America. And then, ang galing doon sagot nung isa. Sabi niya, oh, President, would you like to answer that question? And Donald Trump says, you know, you have to make it sure. Kailangan mo siguruduin if that is a compliment or if that is a... He made fun out of the question. And you know what I like about this guy? He has this winner mentality. He doesn't allow any kind of situations like that will discourage him of his candidacy as the president. Kasi alam niya, pag naroroon na siya, mas marami pa ang sisira sa kanya. Sabi nung tao kay Duterte, magkukudeta kami. Well, I'm not saying if you're pro-Duterte, I'm not Duterte. But what I'm saying is this statement. That's what I'm trying to evaluate here. Are you listening? Sabi niya, magkukudeta kami, alis ka namin dyan. Sabi ni Duterte, paano magkukudeta talaga? Sagot, pwede naman, kaya lang pahihirapan ko kayo. Simple as that. Yeah? And it bites the lips. No matter how the other party is doing, talaga, they just can't, you know. There are some people who cannot be affected. They just focus. Amen? Innovators, people are willing to be developed, to learn more, to be improved. Bottom line is they want to grow. You know, I was telling in my prayer, Lord, forgive me, patawarin mo ako, Panginoon, because there's so many things I do not understand. I do not understand the feelings of the people, but I have to say the truth no matter what. If you are in my condition, what will you do? Are you going to hide the truth? Kung kayo nasa kalagayan ko, tatago niyo ba yung totoo? If you see your neighbor's house is burning in fire, will you just keep silent and just watch it? Or are you going to tell your neighbor, oh, naumuwi ka, nasusunog yung bahay mo? Some people are not ready for growth. That is difficult to say. Are you listening? May mga tao hindi handa sa pagbabago. Oh, kung kausapin niya kasi iniingat ako yung emotion niya ni. Bakit? Pag sinabihan mo ba yan, magbabackslide na? I'm an emotional person too. But I'm the kind of person, I always tell to Sister Tesma, you know, sometimes I'm hard person. But if you allow me to realize what I did, and if it is wrong, very humble ako, I will accept that. Lagi ko sinasabi yan, ma, alam mo naman, sasabihin mo lang sa akin. Kasi hindi ko naiintindihan. Pero pag sinabi mo na sa akin, naiintindihan ko, at alam kong mali ako, mali talaga ako. Tatanggapin ko yun. Kahit paslit na bata, pag sinabi ganito ka, ganyan, I will accept that because I want to grow. So next time, this truth you do, blah, 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 blah. Hello? And that's why there's a lot of problem. We try to cover things that could be addressed well when it's still small, the issue is still small. Amen? Maliit pa lang sana yung issue, natapos na sana, pero hindi. You try to cover your feelings. Hanggang lumaki na lumaki, sumabog ka na, galit ka na sa mundo, galit ka na sa tao, galit ka na rin kay Lord. Dinamay mo pa ang church, ayaw ko na sa church. Hello? No, we must be reasonable people. Amen? We talk with reasons, we don't talk with emotions only. Yes, we love the people. The law says, even though I forgive you, there's a law says that you have to be punished justly. Pumatay ka. Pinatawad kita, pero kailangan mong pagbayaran ang kasalanan mo. Hello, are you listening? There's responsibility. Innovators want to grow. Early adopters, they are those who know a good idea when they see it. Ano? When we talk about church building, many years ago, the idea of moving from my house, putting the church here, 10 years ago, I was talking to 3 families, I said, we will not grow here, we need to go out of my house, we must put the church outside. Let me find a place for you. And they said, yes. But they are not the early adopters, they did not... I soon found out I was the one alone standing trying to pursue that vision. At nakakagulat kasi pag naitayo na, tsaka palang magsasabi na tama nga, Pastor. Hello? But there are the early adopters who says, kaya natin yung Pastor. And there's the middle adopters. They are the majority. They will respond to the opinion of others. That's why they do not grow. Tumutugon sila sa sinasabi ng iba. Probably they do not have the right information. So it's very important you assess the right information, accurate information, so they can respond right. Pag mali ang information na rinig, mali rin ang sagot. Tama? Pag tama ang informasyon, tama rin ang sagot. Ang tamang kwento, sagot, tamang sagot. Maling kwento, maling sagot. At bago ko masabi yung totoo, you were already drawn by your emotions and your tears is flowing. And the guy who doesn't know anything, cannot defend himself, what a pity of him. Because he cannot defend himself. And that, what we call immaturity. That is a personal assassin. Late adopters, they are the group to endorse an idea. They often speak against proposed changes. Wala ka na sinabing mabuti, lahat na lang kontra. Ang gaganda na ng mga messages na narinig. The problem is, these people just cannot handle what is true. There was one strong statement today that I heard, and I do not know if you heard it. It came from the Vatican. Now they are proving a sexual union between 2 males and 2 females. What can you say about that? That is a strong statement. Would you imagine one senator agree to that? Sino ngayon matalino, tayo o siya? May nag-agree, isang senadora, babae. Okay sa kanya. Ma, ay, have you forgotten? Unless you are not founded in biblical principles, then you will not understand what I'm talking about. And the last thing is the laggards. They are always against change. Ayaw nila ng pagbabago. Their commitment is to the status quo and the past. Often they try to create division within the organization. I like what Jack Hayford said, the founder of the Fourth Church of the Foursquare Gospel in the world. He said, pastors are not called to become popular. Are you listening? We are called in obedience and faithfulness. I like that. It comforts me a lot. Sabi niya, hindi tayo tinawag mga pastor para maging popular and comfort people. We are called to become obedient. Brother Eddie Villanueva, founder of JIL, says, listen, the quality of your life in eternity depends on the quality of your obedience and faithfulness serving the Lord. I hope you got that. You get that. The quality of your life in eternity depends on the quality of your obedience and faithfulness in serving the Lord. May nakakakita o wala, tama o mali sa paningin ng tao, you just do the right thing. And when you do that, in order to do that, you must be a grown-up man, able to discern. What does growth mean? You are the kind of person you are able to discern what is right and what is wrong. And when the grown-up man says, this is the right, he stick to that even up to the point of death. Ang taong matalino, marunong pumili ng tama. At pag pinili niya yung tama, hindi niya lamang pinili. It's another thing when you choose the right thing and you stick to the right thing. Are you listening? Pinili mo yung tama, pero manatili ka dyan sa tama. No matter how people sway, you stay there. And as far as God is concerned, there's no wrong with God. Walang mali sa Panginoon. Merong mali sa atin. Are you listening? Hindi mo ipagkakamali ang Diyos kahit kailanman. Yung paglapit sa Kanya, hindi mo ipagkakamali. Huwag mo siyang idamay. You know what? You have to mature. You need to mature. We need to mature. We need to grow. And then change will occur. That's it. Amen? You love me? I love you. Did I hurt you? Well, good for you. Pastor, you hurt me. Does it mean we're enemy? You know, when I deal with problems, niiwasan ako, tapos biglang, sasabihin ko sa kanya, do we have conflicts? You know, that word really cornered. Parang mo siya kinornet. Do we have conflicts? Kasi, you cannot avoid problems all the time, amen? You cannot avoid conflicts. Lahat na, pero ano, iiwas ka, natumanda ka na, umiwas. Hindi mo harapin, tanggapin mo. Mali ka eh, mali talaga mo. Kamali ako. Pero, my problem will not the end of our relationship, amen? Yung away natin, hindi nang magbukunsot, hindi na natin pagiging magkaibigan. I'll tell you, I have friends who become my enemy who did the great worst problem ever sa buhay ko, pero now still my friend. I have pastor friend who we grew up child. Mas matanda pa pagkakilala namin kaysa kay Pastor Clem. He's a pastor, I'm a pastor. We have problems, right? We're human. We're silent for 10 years, 12 years. Hindi kami nag-uusap. Dahil talagang ako ang nagrabyado sobra. Pero maniwala kayo sa hindi. To God be the glory. Ako pa nag-reach out sa Kanya. Sabi ko, namimiss kita. Kailangan ka dito. Andito na kami lahat. Siguro gulat na gulat din siya. At ngayon, he's communicating to me. And you know, you don't have permanent grudges. You only have permanent friends. Para rin tayong politiko, wala tayong permanenteng kaaway. Amen? Kaya, You know, you have to renew your mind. You know, you have problem with me, to tell you honestly, I have no problem with you. I'll talk to you anywhere I can see you, I'll say hi. But if you don't say hi to me, it's okay. I cannot cry over spilled milk. Hindi ako pwedeng umiyak sa isang tapon, gatas na natapon. I don't mind that. You know, if you have problem, then it's your problem. Ikaw magdadala, you know. At sana wag ganun. We have to grow, amen? And church is not perfect. There's a lot of imperfections. King David committed adultery. Moses was not able to enter the promised land. What makes you think you will not commit mistake? Hello? Ang galing mo pumuna, pero pag ikaw ang pinuna, iyakin ka pala. Hello? Ang galing mo mag-block, mag-unfriend. Pag in-unfriend ka, iyak-iyak ka rin. Di ba? Bago mo gawin yon, tingnan mo kung kaya mo rin. Magbablock ka ng tao, tapos... Well, is this emotion? Am I hurting you people? I love you. I want you to grow. I want to grow. Hello? It's Pastor's Appreciation Month. Will you appreciate me later? Okay, I love you guys. I just have to do my job. This was not written in my handout, but you know, that's what I feel saying to you. I love you and I want you to grow. Don't hold grudges. Love people. Love their imperfections. Learn how to say sorry. Learn to forgive people. Accept people. Amen? Salamat, binigyan ako ng, last na lang ito, salamat, binigyan ako ni Lord ng asawang napakamatiisip, maunawain. Pag nagagalit siya sa akin, sabi, ikaw lang ang ganyan. I'm hard. Hindi mo nararamdaman. Hindi mo talaga nararamdaman. Insensitive ka talaga. Ma, paunawa mo. Gusto ko, ako nga rin, I'm lost. Tell me, ano ba? Ganito kayo. Ay, naku, talaga, sorry. Patawarin mo, ngayon wala naiintindihan. Hindi ko alam, may nakikinig pala sa amin. Nagda-try pa ko, may nakikinig palang isang matalinong babae. Pag-uwi sa bahay, sabi niya, alam mo, Sister Tess, pasto, natutuwa ako sa inyong dalawa. He is a single parent. She is a single parent. Hiwalay siya sa asawa niya. Siya'y napakabait. It is the loss of the guy. Ang sabi niya sa akin, natutuwa ako sa inyong dalawa kasi pag nag-usap kayo, napaka-open. Si pastor, natutuwa ako sa attitude niya, open, kahit nasasaktan. Naging blessing pa pala ako that time. Hello? Well, I hope you get my point. Why don't we stand up and let us pray? Lord, thank you, Lord, that you can see our imperfection. We are limited in many ways. There are some things that you want to deal in our lives, Lord. And sometimes we are difficult to deal with, Lord. We're not willing to be changed. But today, Lord, we are asking by the grace of Jesus, Lord, to help us overcome those imperfections. Help us to improve ourselves so that we will grow in our Christian life, able to handle things that are difficult to handle. Panginoon, salamat sa mga puso na mababa at handang tumanggap ng aming mga kamalian. Patawarin mo kami, Panginoon, kung nagiging isip bata kami at asal bata kami, Panginoon. Bigyan mo kami ng puso na handang magpabago sa inyo. At salamat, Panginoon, dahil alam namin, hindi man namin maabot ang perfection not until we go out of this world. But we know, Lord, that you will be able to raise us as good people, good Christians that has a living testimony and that has a pure heart. Panginoon, salamat sa inyo sa umagang ito. And we thank you, Lord. This is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Hello po. So before we end our service po, let's pray muna po. Lord, thank you for this day. Maraming salamat po sa araw po na ibinigay niyo po sa bawat isa. Maraming salamat po na nandito po kami at nagkatipunin po na narinig po yung word niyo. And Lord, naway sana po hindi naman dumaan dito sa aming kabilang tenga. Bagkus, ito yung manahan sa aming puso. Lord, that may apply po namin yung word na narinig po namin for today, Panginoon, na yung message ko na inirely niyo sa bawat isa, Panginoon, ay magbago sa kani-kanilang buhay, Lord. And Lord, thank you for the blessings and the guidance. And I declare the blessings for this week, Panginoon. I declare blessings for everyone, Lord, na nandito at sa bawat isa po, Panginoon, na kahit hindi man sila nandito ngayon sa church because of the limited capacity, Panginoon, I declare, Lord, na magkakaroon po ng blessings ang bawat isa, Panginoon. And Lord, naway ingatan niyo po ang bawat isa sa pag-uwi and lalo na po ngayong pandemic, Lord, ingatan niyo po ang bawat isa, Lord. Yakapin niyo po sila ng pagmamahal niyo, Panginoon. Maraming salamat po, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. And ayun po, so ipag-pray din po natin yung special concern about mental health po since yun nga po, mental health po ay isa sa pinakamatinding kalaban po natin ngayong pandemic. So, ayun po, let's pray po ulit. Lord, I know, Lord, na maraming nakakaranas ng iba't ibang klase ng mental health, Lord, like anxiety, depression, or kung ano pa pong iba yan, Panginoon. And Lord, I pray, Lord, na magkaroon, Lord, ng healing, Lord, na magkaroon po na mapanatag ang bawat isa, Panginoon, na makonquer nila, Lord, yung struggles na nararamdaman nila ngayon, Lord. I know, Lord, na yung pandemic, Lord, ay mas naka-apekto ito, Panginoon, sa aming mental health. And Lord, naway yakapin po kami, Panginoon, na despite of pandemic, Lord, na ipakita niyo, Lord, yung grace niyo, Lord, nandiyan kayo sa amin, Lord, na hindi niyo kami iniwan, Lord, sa struggles namin, Panginoon. Panginoon, kasama ka namin naglalakad, Panginoon. Paramdam mo po ang pagmamahal sa bawat isa. And I hope, Lord, na yung nakakaramdam ng ganito, Panginoon, ay makaramdam din po ng comfort sa inyo, Panginoon. Panginoon, bless and guide us po in our decisions, Panginoon. Maraming salamat po. Yes, po, Lord Jesus. Thank you po. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. And yun nga po, and that's the end of our service. So, mag-ingat po ang bawat isa sa atin. And God bless us all.